Hi Cancer, welcome to your mid-March 2022 general love reading. This is your girl Mermaid Scales Tarot. Thank you so much for joining me here. This is a general love reading for the Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and or any other strong placement for the sign of Cancer. This will not resonate with every Cancer that watches this message, and because this reading is general, not every single message may be for you, so please only take what resonates and leave what doesn't for someone else who needs to hear that message. And if this reading is not for you at all, Cancer, I highly suggest checking out your other signs in different placements. Hi, Crosswatchers, you're very welcome here if you're interested in a Cancer. Who wouldn't be? I'd like to remind Cancer and Crosswatchers that energy is fluid. This simply means you may feel like I'm describing a certain situation in the reading where you feel the roles are flipped or reversed, and that's completely okay. You are more than welcome to use your own discretion to flip those roles if that resonates with your specific situation the best. All right, Cancer, let's get this reading started. I'm going to go ahead and use my sound bowl to clear and set the energy as always. So if you are listening to this using headphones or the volume's kind of loud right now, I do suggest turning it down a little bit just for this part because I don't want your ears to hurt. So let's get this started. All right, so let's see what's happening for my Cancers, mid-March to end March for love and romance, Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, anyone dealing with the Cancer, what's going on in Cancer's love life at this time, Spirit? What will be happening, unfolding in Cancer's love life at this time? Tell me about it. Woo! You got two cards, Cancer. Okay, so let's see. Reconciliation and love yourself first. Whoa, Cancer. You know what was interesting? Sometimes I say the messages or, you know, tell you guys what I see or hear with the sound bowl. And I was just like, I kind of want to just get into the reading. But I heard you got mail. And I also heard check your inbox. And I feel like some of you have been checking your inbox, checking to see if someone is going to, like, come back. I feel some of you have had this, like, feeling about it, and they're here. They're coming back mid to end March. Someone you haven't heard from in a while, I'd say, for a few months. For some of you, I'm even hearing September. They could be a Virgo, they could be a Libra, maybe perhaps, but yeah, I feel though that Cancer, someone had to leave this situation, whether it was you or them. You guys stopped talking because you weren't getting enough. You weren't happy with what they were providing. They were either in and out of your life, only messaging you when they wanted to, not showing you that they cared enough. And that's the one way to lose a Cancer. Cancer may try to hold it out. Cancer may try to hope for the best, but eventually Cancer leaves when they don't feel honored, respected, secured in the connection. And what I feel about this Cancer, this combination here with reconciliation and love yourself first, is that some of you guys had to go just to show this person that you're not just a side piece. You're not just a hit and quit. You're not just someone who's going to be taken advantage of. Of course, Crosswatchers, this could be vice versa, right? The roles could definitely be reversed, but this is the storyline I'm getting for someone here tuning into this message. And you showed them. I wonder if they kind of at first thought, oh, whatever, no big deal, I'll just move on. But as time goes on, they're really starting to miss you. They really started to think about you. They were checking your social media. They were looking at your stories, but they were still silent. And I think they've kind of been going through this realization about how they treated you, going about this realization of, you know, how good it was with you, being with you, taking you on dates, having you as theirs. And if it wasn't even a committed connection, it's almost as if like something with you felt solid out of, you know, any other people they've seen or dated within the last couple years. Something with you was a bit different. And I think they realized that they mistreated you. They do realize that they should have taken you more seriously. And maybe even some of them are realizing they took you for granted. So I feel, Cancer, if you've been kind of feeling their energy, you've been seeing them pop in your stories of who viewed them and stuff like that. Yeah, they've been thinking about you and they've been waiting for the right time to come back. But someone had to really fully realize how to treat the other person with respect. Okay. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, right, Cancer? I'm seeing the letter L for someone out there, first, middle, last initial. I also see the letter R, first, middle, last initial can mean something to someone. But, whew, Cancer, yeah, they respect you now. I don't know what took them so long. I don't know what took them, you know, a bit of time to wake up. But during this time where you guys were just not talking, where you were doing your own thing, they've been realizing a lot. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. So it's by pushing them away or pulling back or whatever you did that really changed the whole vision of how they saw you. Where maybe at first they thought it was just a good time where they were just trying to play around, but now they're taking you a lot more seriously and they want to come back into your life. Whew, all right, let's get more cards. Tell me more about this energy surrounding Cancer and love and romance spirit. Ooh, Cancer. We have twin flame here. And this has been appearing in Cancer readings. Interesting. And it says this is a divine counterpart connection. Wow. So, yeah, I feel like Cancer, this whole chase was for a reason, meeting this person was for a reason. Some of you, I don't know how much you know about twin flames, but they're very much the case of when one twin flame is more awakened than the other, where there has to be a process of separation, where there has to be a process of realization and awakening. And I feel that during this whole time you guys have been silent with one another, someone's been waking up to this. Someone has been realizing that the connection, because they think about you so much, because they've been, you know, been trying to date other people, but they still think of you at the end of the day, there's a reason for that. And some of you, you are on a twin flame journey. This person, whoever they are, is your twin flame. And I don't know if they believe in it, right? They could use different words. But Cancer, they're more affected by this than maybe you even think. And some of you already feel it out, your Cancers. You feel it out, but you weren't going to do anything more if it was not going to be met halfway. And I understand that. They understand that. Wow. So let's see what the tarot has to say. Let's get the tarot cards going. Tell me more about this energy surrounding Cancer. Tell me more about this energy, Spirit. Ooh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Let me pull all the cards out. Wow, all these so far are water cards. You could definitely be dealing with another Cancer, perhaps, Scorpio or Pisces, or someone with strong water in their chart. Let's keep going. Tell me more. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Yeah, Cancer, they really didn't know what they had till it was gone, okay? They really didn't understand it. They tried to move on. They couldn't. No one felt the same the way you did. That is very clear. Yeah, wow. Mm-hmm. All right, Cancer, let's get right on into this. Bottom of the deck. Ace of Swords. So air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. You could have air in your chart. You could be dealing with the air sign. Does not have to be the case in order for this reading to resonate. So for some of you, the silence has already been broken between the two of you. For some of you, this person just came back and you're wondering what their intentions are. You're wondering if this is something that is going to disappoint you again. And they definitely feel the guard you have a little bit up. I think, Cancer, that others of you, this is something they've been having on their mind for a while, to reach out, to break the silence, to say their piece, to give you clarity on the situation. And for a lot of you, there was no clarity. You never got an answer from them, or at least a solid answer from them. You know, you knew that they would come back every once in a while. You knew they would reach out when they're starting to miss you after a certain period of time, but you never knew if they ever felt the same way. You never knew if they actually wanted to move forward in this situation or just have it be this stagnant, you know, energy that's been existing between the two of you. But others of you with this Ace of Swords, this is where they're getting it now. They're understanding. They have awakened to something within this connection that has changed their mindset permanently about you and what they want with you. I feel that with this Ace of Swords, this was something that kind of spirit hit them over the head with. And now that they see this connection, they see what the whole situation is between the two of you, the good and the bad, what they didn't do, I think they really do want to make things right with you, Cancer. I tell you, if I saw things like the Seven of Swords, the Devil, Seven of Cups, I'd be saying a whole different story. But this really does sound like they're clear on what they want in this. They're clear about how they feel about you. It took them a bit, yeah. But now that they've awakened to this, I don't think they're going back to the same old, you know, drama, the same old habits, the same old patterns that destroyed this connection. And I think they're hoping to change your mind about it too, Cancer. Especially because they get it. They get why you may have been putting a block. They get why you may not have been reaching out. But I think they're looking to change your mind on this whole situation. So let's get into it. Dead center, Three of Cups, Cancer energy. Yeah, and this is what I mean about that reconciliation energy. They're going to reconcile. They're, you know, and almost as if it was inevitable that this person was going to come back, especially because this is a divine counterpart connection, right? I do feel that they're going to ask you on a date. I do feel like they want to take you out somewhere, go out somewhere with you. That was your favorite bar, your favorite restaurant you two would go to. They want to see you again. They've been missing you. They've been craving you. They've been wanting to see how they could enter your life again, where you guys could make amends, make up for it. You were a lot of fun to be around. You were someone that made them laugh. You were someone that they always had a good time with. Their friends really like you. Maybe you guys even met through mutual friends, or you have mutual friends. And maybe, you know, in that regard, you've seen each other out during certain events and places, but you guys never really connected on that level again that you did before. But with this Three of Cups, yeah, I definitely do feel like they want to just make peace with you. Holding back has been hard enough. But I do feel, Cancer, at the dead center of this, that they do want to say that they want to have you around again, that there is something special here. They feel good around you. They feel good having you in their life. But what's crossing this is the Four of Cups, more Cancer energy. Dissatisfaction, remembering that dissatisfaction that made you pull away or made you push away. I even feel, Cancer, that to some extent, you even got bored with the same things they were doing all the time. The same loop around, the same in and out. You know, it just kind of not only grow like anger or resentment, just boredom. Just you're not complacent with how things were going. You were kind of annoyed that it always kind of had to be their way, on their terms, of when they wanted to engage in this connection and when they didn't. I feel like with this Four of Cups, they even got a little bit comfortable. Too comfortable, maybe even at your house, leaving things at your house, not doing the dishes, you know, that type of thing. I almost feel like with this Four of Cups energy here too, that for some of you, they kind of, I don't think they would ever admit this, but they would kind of look to you as being the person that would like take care of their emotional needs, always make them feel better, always cheer them up. But the problem was, is that it wasn't reciprocated. I'm kind of getting that feeling. With this Four of Cups energy, Cancer, you're just worried if you're still not going to be happy if you were to give this another chance, another go with this person. And I even feel that, like, on your end, Cancer, that maybe it's even like you're wondering if the feelings of the passion and the love that existed at first, can that be reignited? I think it can, definitely, but some of you, a part of you has kind of numbed yourself out to this person in some sort of way, and that could have been protection. That could be, you know, just not trusting them yet and keeping it a little bit silent. I do feel like, Cancer, you may, again, emotionally be on guard. You're not going to make the effort until you see more from them. But they definitely miss, like, coming over to your house. They definitely miss spending the night at your house. They definitely miss, I don't know. Did you do their laundry, or did you guys do laundry together? Did you have a washing machine when they didn't have one? Because I'm smelling laundry detergent. But almost, yeah. You in a sense, they miss the way you just cared so much. And it's not like you had to write in a romantic love poem that went on for a couple pages. It was more of just the things you did that showed that you cared about the people you love, the people you have feelings for. They saw that with the way you did that with your friends, your family members. And they know they have to do more. What's crowning this is the Knight of Cups, Pisces energy. They still have feelings. They still have feelings, and I feel, Cancer, they're coming back correct, I want to say. They're not going to be on subliminal stuff. They're not going to be passive aggressive. You can trust what they have to say. I know it's like you're asking a bit much, Mermaid. And again, like, you guys know your situations better than I do, but with this Knight of Cups in the upright, if they are going to give you an apology, it's something that's heartfelt. If they do have something to say in regards to how they feel, how they've missed you, it is honest. With this Knight of Cups, someone could drive a black car. And someone has like something in their mirror, like an air freshener or like a rosary or like a little thing on their, yeah, you get what I'm saying. I forget what those things are called. Comment it below. But yeah, they're coming with the heart and the motivation to really heal something between the two of you, to make amends. They're coming with a white flag waving, Cancer, because they know that's the only way they can get you back. They know that they can't come back on some playboy, playgirl, seductive things. That's not going to impress you. They know they're not going to come back aggressive. Why haven't you reached out? Like, excuse me? That's not going to work either. They know they have to come completely genuine from the heart. And they are. You'll see that clearly from them. I'm also seeing someone with like black sunglasses too. Yeah, and someone's like Avi even on social media. Or someone posted a picture with black sunglasses, or that's someone's go-to shades. What's rooting this is the Three of Pentacles. Now, we do have two threes here. Someone's birthday could be July 3rd, July 13th, perhaps June 23rd. Someone could be seeing 33. But they want to work on this. And let me tell you something, Cancer. During this time apart, like I said, they may have been trying to, thinking it's over between the two of you, whatever. They've been trying to dip their toes, dip their feet in other water. It did not compare to what they had with you. And honestly, like, I even feel like if they were trying to date someone else, they were caught looking at your social media where they were caught looking at old pictures of you that they had by the person they were seeing. And they're like, who's this? It was you, Cancer. And even for those of you I was kind of picking up on seeing each other somewhere public, like if you went downtown and you saw them at a bar, or you went to someone's house and they were there, maybe they were even with someone else, it messed them up a little bit seeing you again in person. And you do look really good. You did look really sexy, really attractive. And they still think about what they should have said to you, if that does resonate with you. The other person noticed too. For those of you, again, if it's that specific, yeah, the other person noticed how who they were trying to date was still stuck on you. They want to work on it. They do genuinely want to work on the connection. And they, even if they're, I mean, for someone out there, even if there is someone else that has been lingering in there, you know, someone they've been dating, they would drop them like that for you. They would. And I think they're thinking of doing it to show you how serious they are with you. In the recent past, or the past of this connection, is the Strength card, Leo energy. Yeah, and what I feel about this card specifically is the whole holding back, right? They wanted to reach out. They wanted to say it, that they're sorry, or they wanted to, you know, try to start something again with you. But I feel Spirit was just holding them back, sending those intuitive messages to hold back, because they weren't in the right alignment before. Again, like, this reconciliation is coming because they've taken the time to really understand this connection, understand themselves, and understand what they want with you. And if they were to come back on their lower vibration, lower frequency, where you guys left this situation, it wouldn't have worked. But Spirit has been working with them to become more of the person you need them to be. And Spirit has, in a sense, been watching over this whole connection as you guys have been moving on and doing your own thing. I feel that very strongly here. And the bond that you guys have created through this has been, you know, cemented, I want to say, with this Strength card here. I do feel someone may have been working on their body a little bit, toning up a little bit, weightlifting, squatting, sit-ups. It's been working. They notice, even if it's just through social media. If not, they saw you, that's where they saw it, right? But with the Strength card in the back, for the majority of people I'm feeling with this, yeah, the whole time they've been holding back, wanting to reach out, but knowing it's not the right time. And I think that was either through their own recognition of that, or through Spirit kind of reiterating it to them, or sending them messages that it's not right now. It will happen, but not right now. Continue to heal, continue to build yourself. And I think you've been doing the same thing, Cancer, but for different reasons, right? You've been building your own independence. You've been kind of building on your solar plexus chakra to also not reach out, to also hold your ground, to let this person know that you need to be respected more. But they've been craving you. So what you need to know about this connection is Eight of Wands. Fire energy, specifically Sagittarius energy. The passion's been building up on their end. In Cancer, it could have been on your end too, you know, missing them, wanting them, yearning for them. But again, you were not going to break your expectations. You were going to hold your ground. And it's going to be rewarded. It's going to be seen. I feel that they've been dying to tell you everything that they've been going through, what's been going on in their life, what you guys have kind of missed out on, what they want to do to further this, what they want to do to expand this. You know, some of you, they're going to message you online. They're going to send you a DM, or they're going to, you know, call your number, I feel. They want to talk. They want to speak. And everything that they want to say is coming from the heart. I want to say with this Eight of Wands, even if you guys are at a distance from each other now, someone may have moved since you guys stopped talking, they're still wanting to see this through. They still want to start this reconnection with you. And if need be, I feel they would travel to see you face to face to talk this out. I know I feel like this is all going to start by electronic communication and then build further from that. But I think the timing's ready now between the two of you to break the silence and to speak on everything you've been wanting to say, what they've been wanting to say. Wow, Cancer. Okay, so to see the likely outcome of this situation, what is likely to happen by the end of this month, how is this all going to unfold? What are they going to do? We're going to go ahead and take this to Vimeo for the extended reading. I'm going to overturn this card here to show you the likely outcome of the situation. And I'm going to pull some Oracle cards as well to dive deeper into this connection and into this situation. So if you'd like to join me for the extended reading, open up the description box and you'll find the link to Vimeo, which will take you to the extended reading. But if this is where you depart, Cancer, I really hope that this has resonated with you, that this has given you clarity, insight, healing, and guidance in regards to your love life at this time. If it has, please let me know. Drop a comment below, hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. I love you, Cancer, very much, and I'll see you next time. Take care, Cancer.